Hey everyone, in this tutorial I will show you how to get started with live streaming using OBS. You will learn exactly how to set up your stream and what the different parameters in OBS affect. I'm also known as Avalon and I live stream several times a week on Camcord in high quality. Camcord is a mobile app and a desktop application for live streaming. If you want to check it out, follow this link. It's also in the video description. For future episodes on how to stream, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Just click the subscribe button and you will get notified when there are new videos available. Now in this tutorial, I will share with you my settings, the real settings that I am using for live streaming to Camcord or other streaming services. It took me quite some effort to figure out everything as it is now and as I think it works pretty good as it's set up right now. The settings may be a little bit different for you depending on your CPU power from your PC or depending on your network. But still, I think I can give you a very good starting point here. I will explain all the settings in OBS, what they do. To enable you, in case you're having blur effects or lag, to know what parameters affect these and where you can try changes to make it work for your specific environment. First of all, to get started, you need OBS. You can download OBS from this website here. It's obsproject.com. Make sure to select the version you need. So if you're streaming on a Windows PC, make sure to select Windows, select Studio and download this version over here, OBS Plus Browser Source. That is exactly the version I'm using for my live streams from my Windows PC. If you're streaming from a Mac, it's basically the same thing. You select Mac OS X, you select the studio version and download that version. Now, once you downloaded and installed OBS, it will basically look like this. It will just be plain empty. And there are two main points you have to understand first. There is a profile area and there is a scene collection area here. Within the profile, there are the basic settings for your stream, like video quality, stream service, audio settings, all that stuff is within a profile. Within the scene collection, as the name says, it's a collection of scenes. And that's basically what you want to show to the viewer. And you can switch between scenes. A scene can basically be a starting scene, something that you show the viewer at start of your stream. It can be a specific game, or it can be a screen that you want to show the viewer at the end of your stream. So that's within a scene collection. How I use this, typically I will create a new collection whenever I change my overlay, just to make sure I can go back in version. So I kind of use this as a versioning and I will create a new collection with a new date whenever I change my overlay or when I do some changes and I'm not sure whether it will work or trying out things. That's why I have so many scene collections. What I wouldn't recommend is trying to switch between scene collections during a stream, but still you can switch between scenes during a stream. And that will all become a little bit clearer later on in this video. So first of all, what you want to do, you want to create a new profile. You can see I already have a lot of profiles there, but just for this tutorial, I will create a new profile, which is called Tutorial. And you see now here, it is using the profile Tutorial and it is using the scenes Tutorial. So let me also quickly show you how this works. Basically, you just go on scene collection, you click new, and yeah, because I already have the tutorial, I cannot create it. I will create a tutorial too, and that's it. And now I'm using the profile tutorial and I'm using the scenes tutorial too. Now, when you look at this window, you basically see two areas, the scenes and the sources. In the scenes, it's basically showing you all the scenes within that one scene collection. So there may be a starting scene, a game scene, and an end scene. In the sources, you may show a specific picture on a start scene. In the end scene, you may show another source, another image. So that's what these two areas are for. Now in the settings, there is the general settings. I don't change anything there, so I just use it as it is. There is the stream settings where you configure basically your streaming service that you are gonna use. And there are the output settings that define how your stream will be that you will be sending to the streaming service. In the audio area, you configure your audio, and in the video area, you configure basically your video size and quality. Now, when you click on stream, by default, it will show you some streaming services that you could select off. You can play with those if you like. I don't use it. I always use custom streaming server. And on custom streaming server, you need the URL of your streaming service and you need a stream key. Be aware to always keep your stream key private, because if anybody knows your stream key, they can stream on your behalf. So always keep that information private. Now, where do you find that information? You need to go to your streaming service. In this tutorial, I will use Camcord. On Camcord, you have this green Go Live button. And once you press that Go Live button, it will show you exactly the information you need. It's the URL and it's the stream key. So you copy the URL, you paste it in there, you copy the stream key, and you paste the stream key in there. And this is it. Now you're basically set for streaming. Now our screen is still black, so we would just stream a black screen. And as soon as I start, as I press the start streaming button here, this stream goes live. Now this depends a bit on which streaming service you use. On Camcord, for example, it will not go live. Instead, it will show you a preview of the stream, which is currently just a black screen, like shown here. And then you have to choose a topic and you have to choose a title. On other services, it may be different. Like on YouTube, for example, on YouTube Live, when you press start streaming, your stream will be live instantly. So be aware that this may be different depending on streaming service that you are using. So I don't want to stream right now, so I'm going to stop it again. And let's go back to the settings. The next thing we're going to look at is the output. So this is basically where you configure your video quality. By default, it will usually be on simple. I recommend selecting advanced. That's what I'm using. In advanced, you have those three areas here. One is streaming, one is recording, and one is audio. In this tutorial, we will focus mainly on the streaming area. I'm gonna focus on recording in another video. And audio is pretty simple. Just put it to 128. That's what I'm using for all those tracks, basically. And you should be fine. So we go back to streaming. In streaming, always leave the encoder on X264. Don't change that one. My experience, this one works best. I tried everything else that might be in this list here. I'm on a Mac, so it will display the Apple hardware encoder and the Apple software encoder, but I tried those and still X264 works best. Also leave audio track on 1 and leave enforced streaming service encoder settings checked. I don't rescale output, I just leave it as it is here. Now in this whole area down here, that's basically where you set the quality of your stream, of your video. And this is basically also the section if you encounter lag or blur in your stream. Typically, this is where you want to go to change things and try different things that might work. So I typically would use a bitrate of 3000. I have a pretty high bandwidth, so I'm fine with 3K as a bitrate. If you're getting lag and you suspect that it's related to network, you may reduce that to maybe 2500. Don't use custom buffer size. Set the keyframe to 2. I had it on auto for quite a while. Then I started doing some streams on YouTube and YouTube told me I should set it below 2 seconds. And that's basically something that is used for synchronization. And Your stream may get behind if it doesn't have that keyframe every 2 seconds. And my experience is with 2 seconds, that works pretty well. Leave a constant bitrate checked. Now the CPU usage. If you're losing frames, it is often related to CPU. So you want to change this setting to ultra fast or super fast. If you're having trouble with your CPU, you can play a little bit with that. If you put it on medium, it will put quite a strain on your CPU. What I use here, typically for camcord, is very fast. So I use 3K bitrate and very fast. If you're having trouble with lag, go down in bitrate or go up here to super fast or ultra fast. Now, if you encounter blur effects, that's typically because you're here in ultra fast, because CPU will be reduced, and if there is very fast movement, it may not be sufficient, and that what causes the blur effects in your video. Now, it is kind of difficult. Either you can have a lag or you can have blur. So you really have to try out which settings work best for you. There is also help. There is a page. So if you need help with these settings, you can also go to the OBS Stream Settings Estimator. And there you can enter your CPU type, your graphics card type, and so on, and it will give you recommendations. My experience is that those recommendations may be very high if you're having a good hardware, but then you will not be able to stream that high quality that you were thinking of. So the link to this is obsproject.com/estimator. I will also put that in the video description. Don't touch the profile, don't touch the tune, that's basically it, and you're set for quality of your video. The next thing you want to check is the audio. You see here, we don't have any audio at the moment. Basically, everything is disabled. In desktop audio is where you will switch on the default, which will be desktop audio on a PC, and on a PC I experienced that works pretty well. On a Mac it is a little bit different. I might cover the whole audio thing in a separate video, because that's a pretty huge topic. So by setting audio on default, you will basically have everything in the stream that plays on your desktop. And then you have to set the microphone. I'm using the Yeti stereo microphone. This, and then I'm set for the audio as well. And the last thing you gotta check is the video. Now for the video, these are very strange values that are in here by default. What you wanna select instead is typically a 1080p resolution. Like this. So you would have your base canvas, which is basically where you do your overlay, which would be 1920 times 1080, and the output also 1920 times 80. So that would be the video size. If you're having trouble, again, having lag, you may want to reduce the base canvas to 720p, which would be So if you're having trouble, reduce to 720p, which would be 1280 times 720 and the output as well. You can also try to leave the base canvas on 1920, 1080 and downscale it to 1280, 720. What I'm using, as I said before, is this one here, which is 1080p resolution. I'm using this bicubic sharpening scaling 16 samples and leave the FPS value on 30. And these are my settings. And now you may have noticed that now I have here the microphone showing all things that I'm talking, and I have the desktop audio. I have a mixer here where I can set the volumes of these. And yeah, I can also add filters to these. And that's basically the basic settings. Now I have a default scene here. I can add a new scene. As I said, I can call it starting screen, Just as a quick example, now let's add a text. I can add a sample text to that starting screen. Sample. There you go. Let's call it Hello World. And that would be a sample text on my overlay. And if I press start streaming right now and go back to my camcorder page, you will see that it is actually streaming that content to camcorder already. So that's the basic settings of my stream. And please make sure to subscribe to my channel. I will feature in another tutorial how to create overlays and how all these things here work together. Thanks for watching and stay awesome!